Hey everyone, Nick here. Now, I've been wanting to do a video about autonomous tractors for a while now, but I needed to find the right angle to get into the story. And those of you who know me or have watched some of the videos know that any angle that includes Lego usually strikes me as the right angle. And talking about autonomous farming is no different. Involve Lego and I'm in. So back in early December, I was at a farming conference where I ran into a bright young fellow with a similar perspective on life and Lego. And now I can finally make this video about robot tractors.
Never say kids can't teach anything. Yep. Hey everybody, welcome to No Ideas Media. I'm Nick Syke and today I am standing with
Luke Silinski.
And what do we have in this box here, Luke?
Well, everybody knows Lego, right? If you don't know Lego, then get help quick.
Oh, they know Lego because we use Lego all the time on our channel, so. Mm-hmm.
So, this is a mini dot and it's built with the Lego robot called Lego EV3, like those cool things that you see on YouTube, like Lego prosthetic arms.
Yeah.
They've been kind of popping up recently. So here, it's just a prototype so far. We're working on a DOT 2.0, so.
Yeah. So for those of us who don't know, what is DOT?
DOT is an autonomous platform. They had an envision of, well, what if we just have one autonomous platform and it can do all sorts of things, and thus the DOT was born.
Cool, Luke's got the important points there, but I'll summarize too. Autonomous tractors are kind of the holy grail of equipment in farming. And in farming, vast amounts of time can be spent pulling various machines through the fields. We're talking like huge man hours spent or wasted, depending on your perspective, just driving equipment. If equipment drove itself, that would be a fundamental change in how we grow food. Now, there are a number of approaches in the works from a variety of companies, but DOT seems to be the company who's currently leading the charge. So let's get into DOT. This admittedly strange-looking diesel-powered platform is designed to do several different jobs in agriculture. The idea is that you have a pretty Spartan frame with the engine and drivetrain and all that, then you can just add different modules as needed, kind of plug-and-play style. Need a sprayer? Here's the 120-foot, 1,600-gallon Connect sprayer made by our video sponsor, Pattison Liquid Systems. Spraying? Covered. Seeding? Grab the seeder. Grain cart? Roller? All of that is already in the works. Really, the sky is kind of the limit here. With some clever engineering, pretty much any equipment used in the fields could be made DOT ready. One platform, many modules, multiple use cases, cool.
So to summarize, this is a Lego version of an autonomous farming implement that you've made here. And what made you want to make this?
Well, when my mom came to me one day and said, Luke, there's this cool thing at farming, farming.com, and it's called DOT, you should go check it out. So I checked out the video and I honestly fell in love. She was just so cute and it was so clever. Like one platform that's big, but not that big, that can do three functions. Sprayer, seeder, the new grain cart they released. Yeah. I actually saw a video on Twitter about that.
And you can talk about Lego models all you want, but like, let's see the sucker in action, right?
So everybody, bear in mind again, this is a Lego demonstration of an actual piece of technology that's out there called the DOT tractor. And I mean, this is kind of how it works.
And you can make one of these. EV3s are only $200 to $300, and you can find them right near a local Lego store. Disclaimer: we are not sponsored by Lego.
But we wish we were.
This should be the sprayer function. She's a bit confused. I don't know why, honestly, sometimes. But that's the thing with agriculture and programming, is there is going to be trial and error.
Okay, I really like this kid. Precocious doesn't even begin to describe it. But talking to Luke about this autonomous DOT tractor and seeing him get excited enough to build it out of Lego, that whole thing speaks to some broader issues in agriculture. There is a lack of new talent heading into the ag industry. Right now, one of the hardest things in agriculture is finding people to do the work that needs to be done. Okay, now there are a ton of reasons for this that we can't even begin to address in a video under 10 minutes long, but the bottom line is, DOT is a solution to the problem of not having enough people to do agricultural work, in that it can do that work autonomously. DOT is also a solution to the people problem in ag in kind of another way too. It's super cool, and even kids think so. It's enticing to a kid like Luke, who might find himself working a rewarding technical career in agriculture, simply because he knows people like himself are desperately needed in the ag industry, and that there is cool work going on there and plenty of cool stuff to be done. I asked Luke for his take on the lack of people going into ag careers. I wanted to know how a younger person looks at this issue and why they might think getting their peers to consider ag careers could be a smart move.
Because as the world becomes increasingly more autonomous and technological, people who are going to be able to write code for computers are going to diminish. And it's especially important for agriculture because there's a lot of coding people who code for farmers yet know nothing about farming, and farmers who help coders but know nothing about coding at all. I'm here, and I guess other people as well are trying to steadily make a wooden bridge, and then in the near future it may be a Golden Gate Bridge. We honestly don't know.
And that's it, really. As ever more sophisticated technology finds its way into the daily operations of a farm, we're going to need more people like Luke, with the expertise and passion to support that technology. If the Lukes of the world, the eager, smart up-and-comers, can learn that their skills are needed in the ag industry, they'll come to it. Because this stuff is cool. Luke said it pretty good there. DOT is a bridge between the new world of automation technology and the relatively old world of big ag machines. Whether it remains a niche kind of bridge or becomes like a massive Golden Gate kind of sea change, either way, it's a win-win, and we'll be watching the DOT story closely. So thanks to Luke Silinski for showing us his ingenious Lego creation. I'm really looking forward to seeing version 2 of that. Of course, we'll follow with more videos there. Thanks as well to Pattison Liquid Systems for sponsoring the video today. Pattison partnered with DOT in early 2018 to start designing this Connect sprayer and some other cool plug-and-play implements too. And hopefully we can get up close with Connect in a video soon, because I think it's worth a closer look. And for that matter, so are Pattison's other products. So if you're in the market for liquid application systems or liquid handling products or spray management systems, Pattison has you covered. Also, thanks to our patrons for supporting No Ideas Media in all of our work, and thank you for watching.